Living organisms and energy production. Now, how living organisms generate this energy, which it requires continuously. We constantly need energy for the life processes to take place. So how this energy is obtained to us? So we know about this. We have studied a little bit about it, that we have these various foodstuffs that we eat provide us with all the necessary nutrients. And out of the nutrients, carbohydrates and fats are the ones which provide us with the energy for performing all the necessary functions and various life processes to take place, everything. So carbohydrates give us 4 kilocalories per gram of energy, whereas fats provide us with 9 kilocalories of energy per gram of fat. But chiefly, the body derives all its energy from carbohydrates. If there are no carbohydrates, then the stored fats in the body are utilized. So just let us have a look on the important points, and then we will be starting with the process of energy production. So carbohydrates are mainly utilized for production of energy required for daily need. Whatever energy requirement is for the daily need of any organism is basically obtained from the carbohydrates. This energy is obtained in the form of ATP. Now, this energy is in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. So this is the actual energy rich molecule, which is the one which gives us the energy. So that is called as ATP. For this purpose, glucose, a type of carbohydrate, is oxidized step by step in cells. This is called cellular respiration. So glucose, which is a simplest carbohydrate, is utilized to generate this energy. And in the previous slide, we had talked about the difference between breathing and respiration. And respiration is taking in oxygen, giving out carbon dioxide, along with the release of energy. So this process of energy release is going to take place inside the cell, and hence it is called as cellular respiration. Whereas breathing is inhalation and exhalation. It is also called as body respiration. So there is a difference between body respiration and cellular respiration. What we are studying here is cellular respiration, that is taking in oxygen and releasing energy inside the cells. Cellular respiration occurs among the living organisms by two methods. One is aerobic respiration, that is oxygen is involved, and anaerobic respiration, oxygen is not involved. So basically, cellular respiration can be done by two methods. One is aerobic and the other is anaerobic. We are going to study both. Aerobic, oxygen is required for production of energy, whereas in anaerobic respiration, energy is going to be produced in absence of oxygen. In aerobic respiration, glucose is oxidized in three steps: glycolysis, tricarboxylic acid cycle, which is also called as the TCA cycle, Krebs cycle, citric acid cycle, which is also called as the CAC, and the third step is electron transfer chain. So in aerobic respiration, the production of energy takes place in three steps. These are the three steps. One by one, we are going to study each step and we will understand how energy is released. Before we begin with the three steps, here is a picture of an animal cell. Because the process of energy production is taking place inside the cell, this picture of animal cell is being shown to you. The first step, that is glycolysis, takes place in the cytoplasm part of the cell. Here you can see the labeling cytoplasm. Here it is. It's a thick solution. Cytoplasm is a thick solution, and it fills each cell, and it is enclosed by the cell membrane. You can see the cell membrane present over here. So cytoplasm is a thick solution, and it fills each cell, and it is enclosed by a cell membrane. What is present in the cytoplasm? It's water, salts, and some proteins are present in it. In short, we can say that any eukaryotic cell will have a cytoplasm in it, and it will have everything that is inside the cell membrane and outside the nucleus. So cytoplasm will contain everything that is inside the cell membrane and outside the nucleus. So one is cytoplasm, and the next two steps, they take place in the mitochondria. So here you can see the labeling mitochondria. You can see mitochondria are found inside the cell in the cytoplasm. It is one of the cell organelles. And here is the process of energy production, that is ATP is going to be released inside the mitochondria. So this picture, just to remind you of these two parts. Let's go on to the first step, that is glycolysis.